Hello everyone, I am Dr. Pragya Sharma from Department of Commerce BADM, Subodh PG Mahila Mahavidyalaya Jaipur. Today, my topic for the presentation is Introduction to Marketing Management, which is basically a subject in BBA second year. Before we begin with what is marketing management all about, let me just go through with some basic terminologies which are related to marketing management. So the first is market. Traditionally, the market was defined as a place where buyer and seller come together to exchange goods and services, which means sellers goods and services ko sell karne aate hain aur buyers goods and services ko buy karne aate hain. But the modern approach defines market as a set of actual and potential buyers of particular product or service. It mainly focuses on buyers and it includes existing buyers and the people who could possibly purchase your product, which are also called as potential buyers. Next terminology is marketing. Marketing involves movement of goods from producer to the consumer, which means marketing mein exchange of goods and services hota hai from producer to the consumer in exchange of money or something of value to satisfy the needs and wants of consumer. Marketing can be defined in the words of marketing management guru Philip Kotler as it is a social process by which individual groups obtain what they need and want through creating offerings and freely exchanging products and services of value with others. Marketing starts even before the actual production process and continues after the goods have been sold. I'll give you an example for this. Big films like Tom Cruise, Mission Impossible and Bahubali, in some movies ke teasers or trailers release ho jate hai 6 months before the actual releasing date of the movie, which creates hype in the market. Aur release hone ke baad bhi in characters ke games banaye jate hain, comics banayi jati hai, goodies banayi jati hai, jisse inki jo marketing hai wo baad tak bhi continue rehti. Next we'll move on to the marketing management. So marketing management is an art and science of choosing target markets and getting, keeping and growing customers through creating, delivering and communicating superior customer values of management. So in simple language, we can say that marketing management involves planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling activities which facilitate exchange of goods and services. For example, if you buy a BMW car, it will satisfy your three-dimensional needs. Kis tarah se ho sakti ho? Ek to ho sakti hai. That will satisfy your need, that will satisfy your want, and it will provide you some extra value or extra edge too. Transportation jo hai, wo aapki facility wali need ko satisfy karega. Luxury car hai, so it will satisfy your want also. And the extra value which I was talking about will be the status symbol. Next, we'll move on to the very important topic which we should understand before moving further, and that is the basic difference between goods and services. So here are some points to differentiate between them. First is nature. Services are intangible in nature. It is not possible to see, touch, measure, weigh, taste, smell or touch them. Whereas we can touch, smell, see, taste, not every time, sometimes, and measure goods, which means they are tangible in nature. Next basis of differentiation or the comparison is transfer of ownership. When buying a service, the service ownership is not transferred to the end customer. For example, if you buy a ticket for an airline, then the airline is definitely not yours. But if you buy a car, then the car is yours because car is a good and ownership transfers in the case of good. Next basis of comparison is return. Goods can be returned for a refund or credit if they don't meet your expectation or if you are not satisfied or if they are defective. But services cannot be returned once they have been provided, as the production and consumption of a service occurs simultaneously. Next basis is separability. Goods once produced are separated from the producer, whereas services are generated and consumed within the same time frame. Moreover, it is very difficult to separate a service from a service provider. They are inseparable. For example, a barber is a part of haircut service that he delivers to his customer. A haircut is delivered and consumed by the customer simultaneously. In this example, barber is a service provider and haircut is service availed by the consumer. Next point of differentiation or the basis of comparison is variability. In case of products, mass production, which you can also say that bulk production or large scale production is common. And mass production means uniformity of or homogeneity. Homogeneity here means that the products are identical in shape, size, appearance, or weight maybe, etc. So however, services involve a lot of manual labor due to which the quality may vary each time and the services become heterogeneous in nature. So here the heterogeneity means that all the services which are being produced or which are being provided are not identical in shape, size, appearance, weight, etc. Next point of differentiation is storage. Goods can be stored for future use, but services are time bound. That is, if not availed in the given time, then they cannot be stored. For example, घर का सामान जो अपन लाते हैं, groceries and all, वो अपन काफी लंबे time के लिए ला सकते हैं. But जैसे अपन ने ऊपर देखा था haircut का example, that occurs at the same time, so that cannot be stored. So the next and the last point of differentiation is production and consumption. Production and consumption of service happens at the same time. This does not mean that the raw material is not present to provide the service. For example, in a restaurant, a dish is made only after you order for it. The raw material and the chef might be present, but the production does not begin unless and until there is a customer to consume the service. Let's take an example of Pizza Hut. So in Pizza Hut, chefs are present, raw material to make pizza are present, but they are waiting for your order. So this is all about basic things which we should know before getting into the insight of marketing management. That's all for our first session. Next, I'll be taking in another sessions. Thank you.